Imagine having to read the labels on everything from food to shampoo just because you're scared of a certain ingredient.
That's a reality for about one in every 130 people. Tonight, a look at the disease that causes the fear and how those living with it cope.
Music comes naturally to Samuel Pierce Rulin. An accomplished cellist, he attends music school in New York. While he can belt out classical music with ease, he's struggled with something far more simplistic his entire life, food.
Along about 6 months, 9 months, somewhere in there, he started to develop abdominal pains, cramping, bloating.
Samuel's dad, internist Dr. Richard Pierce Ruland, and mom Susan felt helpless when Samuel was a child.
We'd gone through colic with both of the kids, but this took a new level. This was absolutely inconsolable. Middle of the night screaming, you could just tell that this was far and above anything that we had seen and I'd seen in my medical training before.
Eating was a challenge, and Samuel's development came to a halt.
It became evident that he was falling off the growth charts, what pediatricians would call failure to thrive.
But the Pierce Rulins finally got a diagnosis, celiac disease, at the time a little-known autoimmune disease. It's triggered by gluten, which causes a person to produce antibodies that destroy normal tissue in the body. It commonly attacks the gastrointestinal tract.
You can have malabsorption, colon cancer, osteoporosis. The systems do not respond well to that sort of ongoing attack by these antibodies.
As the Pierce Rulins discovered, gluten is everywhere.
Wheat, barley, oats, and rye. I have to watch out with like shampoo and soap and pet food. I'm sensitive enough that I can't absorb it through my skin.
The diagnosis initially turned the family's life upside down. Susan decided to go completely gluten-free in their kitchen. Not an easy task in the 90s.
Early on, Susan and I would struggle with food labeling. You couldn't trust that foods were gluten-free.
Even school became a challenge. Teachers wanted to separate Samuel for snacks, craft projects, and lunch, so Susan decided instead to homeschool him.
I don't think it really affected me until I started going out with friends to like restaurants and things like that.
College brought a whole new set of problems. Samuel can't have a roommate.
If we did have a roommate, then there's a much higher risk of cross-contamination.
And his meals are still cooked in Racine.
I will freeze individual portions of his food.
It's just cooked here and frozen and sealed up in a plastic bag and shipped to me.
It's a way of life for the Pierce Rulins, and things are getting easier.
Thankfully, over the last decade or so, foods have been more completely labeled.
Dr. Pierce Rulin says the disease had been underdiagnosed and is recently getting more attention.
A recent study suggested that it occurs in about one in 130 people worldwide.
Now restaurants are taking notice. Far more people seem to be going gluten-free for various reasons. Restaurants have to answer the call.
People like a hamburger joint. People like coming to a bar, you know, even if you're gluten-free, a vegan, or a vegetarian.
When Stack Bar opened 6 months ago, owner Tim Dixon wanted everyone to be able to eat there.
I became acutely aware of the disease when my daughter started showing symptoms.
So Stacked offers gluten-free buns and other items.
We have 24 a week that we order and we go through them.
Samuel says some chain restaurants are also getting on board, and it's all music to his ears.
Celiac disease is not the only medical reason people choose a gluten-free diet. Many practitioners and parents believe it also helps those suffering from autism.